There are many similarities between Rhus tox and Dulcamara. Both medicines have same causation, that is, getting wet after being overheated, exposure to damp rainy weather, and working in damp places like basements and cellars. Both medicines have same general aggravation in the night and after exposure to damp cold weather. And both medicines have general amelioration from motion and warmth. But Rhus tox and Dulcamara are totally different in cases of fever. Rhus tox has burning heat all over the body. There is thirst and dryness in mouth, tongue and throat. Rhus tox is very restless at night and midnight, and often patient changes his position in the bed, and this change of position is a motion that gives him relief. Aconite is very similar to Rhus tox, but anxieties and fears of Rhus tox are less as compared to aconite, and aconite does not get any relief from motion. Rhus tox is useful in typhoid fever also. Rhus tox is very restless physically and mentally in cases of fever. Dulcamara has low grade fever, and that fever is often associated with catarrhal symptoms like tears gushing from eyes and running nose. And fever is low grade up to 100 degree Fahrenheit. And fever is always associated with chilliness, and chilliness is a prominent feature of the fever. And fever generally comes in the evening. Often delirium may be associated, but it is also associated with pain all over the body. And both Rhus tox and Dulcamara both have pain all over the body during the fever. I have used Dulcamara in 30 and 200 potency in cases of fever, and Rhus tox in 30, 200 and 1 m potency. So along with fever symptoms, causations and generalities are important.